मॉर्निंग एंड जय हिंद चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन क्लास। दिस इज मैथ्स क्लास एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट लेसन 7 ज्योमेट्री। आवर लेसन 4 डिवीजन इज ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर न्यू चैप्टर लेसन 7 ज्योमेट्री। फॉर ज्योमेट्री वन थिंग रिक्वायर्ड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इज एन इंटरलीफ नोटबुक। यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू डू any work of geometry in your maths notebook. Okay, so for geometry you have to make a two line interleaved geometry notebook. For geometry you need a two line interleaved notebook. You all might be having your SST and science notebook interleaved notebook, that is also interleaved notebook. In interleaved notebook you will find one page is two line printed and on the other page you will find a blank white page. So same you have to get for geometry also. Okay, so for geometry make two line interleaved thin notebook, not a very thick notebook, thin notebook in which whatever work is done in geometry that you will do in your geometry notebook. Okay, so all of you buy a thin notebook for geometry, interleaved notebook, and write anything that is given in geometry in your that notebook. Don't write in maths notebook, children. Okay, so let's start today's class. Today I'm going to tell you few terms which are being used in geometry. Okay, I'm going to explain you those terms, so listen to it very carefully, fold your hands and listen, look at the PDF carefully. Okay, so let's start our class today. Okay children, so we are going to start our lesson 7 geometry. Now look at the PDF everyone. Geometry. So geometry is all about these instruments, protractor, compass. Okay, so let's see what is geometry. Geometry is a branch of mathematics concerned with questions of shape, size, relative position of figures and the properties of space. So what all things you study in geometry? You study about shape, size, relative position of figures and the properties. Okay, so these are the things that are related with geometry. In geometry we study about the shapes and their sizes. Now first thing that is being studied in geometry is point. What is point? Okay, you can see in the picture, this is the picture of a point. So each and everything starts with a point in geometry. Now see, what is a point? A point is an exact position or location on a plane surface. It is important to understand that a point is not a thing but a place. We indicate the position of a point by placing a dot with a pencil. So dot is a point is a dot. Okay, point is a dot and it is always written with a capital letter. Okay, so it is not a thing, point is not a thing, but it shows the location of the place. It locates a thing. Okay, it is a place, it is not a thing. Like wherever you put a point, like suppose if you want to write point A to point B, so point will show that you have to make anything from A to B. So we indicate the position of a point by placing a dot with a pencil. See, this is a picture of dot. This dot is known as point. Okay, straight line. Now what is straight line? A straight line is, you can see a straight line, a line. We all draw line, so it is the straight line. Now what are the characteristics of straight line or line, or what is a straight line? See children, you can see that in this straight line there are two sides arrow. Both the sides you can see the arrow and there are two points on this line, that is AB. So when you see the arrows on both the sides, it is said to be a line. Okay, why? Why these arrows? What does these arrows indicate? ये हमको क्या दिखा रहे हैं ये arrows? If it is a line and it is having arrows on both the sides, what is arrows are showing to us? See, what is a line exactly? A straight path that goes without end in two direction. Line is so a straight path that goes without end in two direction. That means a line has no end. A line has no end. It is infinite. So you can stretch it. You can stretch it how much you want to. So line is infinite. It is never ending. And they have no end points. And line has no end points. That is why you can see the arrows on both sides. You can extend this line this side also. And you can extend this line this side also. In a line, arrow shows infinite. So what is the meaning of these arrows? This shows that line can be stretched infinitely. It is endless. Its limit is endless. Okay, and you can stretch it to any extent you want to. Aap jitna bhi bada us line ko karna chaho, you can do it. Okay, that is why these two arrows are being shown, which depicts that you can stretch the line to any extent. Aap jitna chaho us line ko badha sakte ho both the sides. That is why two arrows are there. Not only one side, you can extend it onto the both the sides. Now see ray. Now we will study about ray. We have seen line. Now we will study about ray. So a line has no end. It can be extended on both the sides. Now see children, what is ray? You can see here point is given and here arrow is there. So arrow is on the one side of the line. Arrow kis taraf hai? Sirf ek side hai. Ray ke only one side hai arrow. Ek taraf point hai. One side point is there. Like you can see the point P. And on the other side you can see the arrow. What is this arrow showing? That this line can be stretched only to one direction. Ye line sirf ek direction mein hum isko bada kar sakte hain. Okay? It cannot be stretched through this P. Okay? This side. There is point. So we cannot extend this line to this side. We can extend it to this side. So ray can be extended in only one direction. Sirf ek taraf ray ko badhaya ja sakta hai. Okay. So ray PQ is written as like this. It is written as like this. Like the line ray is drawn in the same way. It is indicated also in the same way. A arrow is shown only on one side. So how you will read this? Ray PQ, and you will put this sign of arrow to indicate that ray is extended only in one direction. Now we will study about what is ray. A ray can be defined as a path of line that has a fixed starting point but no end point. We have seen that it was starting from P and it was extending to onto Q. It can extend infinitely in one direction. So a ray can be extended in only one direction, whereas line can be extended in both the directions. Line ko hum dono sides se bada kar sakte hain, but ray is extended only in one direction. Okay. Now comes the line segment. Now what is line segment? You can see in this picture. This is the picture of line segment. There are two endpoints in line segment. See? Definition of line segment. A path of line. So, all these things are, all these ray, line segment, they are the part of line. Ye kiska part hota hai? Line ka. Line, you can extend on both the direction. Ray is extended in only one direction. And it has one endpoint and it can be extended in one direction, whereas a line segment is a part of line that has two endpoints. It means it cannot be extended. See children, there are two endpoints. That means it is limited up to this, from this point to this point only. You cannot extend it as per your wish and a definite length. And the length is also very definite. Okay. If it is given 5 cm, it cannot be 5 cm, 5.1 or 5.2 cm. It should be 5 cm. You cannot extend it on your wish. The length is definite. Length jo hai wo same rahegi. You cannot, like in line, in line there is no limit, you can extend it on to both the sides, but in line segment it has two end points and the length is very definite. Length jo hai wo utni hi rahegi, you cannot extend it in any of the direction. Aap kisi bhi side se us line ko bada नहीं कर सकते. एंड हाउ टू राइट लाइन सेगमेंट, सी इट इज रिटन ए बी एंड अ लाइन इज ड्रॉन ऑन इट. ओके, ए बी एंड अ लाइन इज ड्रॉन ऑन इट, दिस शोज दैट लाइन सेगमेंट ए बी. हाउ वी रीड इट, इट इज रिटन लाइक दिस ए बी एंड लाइन इज देयर. एंड हाउ वी स्पीक इट, लाइन सेगमेंट ए बी. ओके, सो नाउ आई होप द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द थ्री थिंग्स इज क्लियर टू यू. वॉट इज अ लाइन? A line has no limit, it can be extended on both the sides. Ray has one end point and it can be extended in only one direction. You have seen that arrow I have shown you in the picture. And what is line segment? A line segment has two end points. Iske two end points hote hain aur isko hum bada nahi kar sakte. And the length will remain the same. Length will remain the definite. Okay? Length same rahegi. Length hum बड़ा नहीं कर सकते इन केस ऑफ लाइन सेगमेंट. ओके, रे को हम एक तरफ बड़ा कर सकते हैं, लाइन को हम दोनों तरफ बड़ा कर सकते हैं, बट इन केस ऑफ लाइन सेगमेंट वी कैन नॉट एक्सटेंड इट ऑन टू एनी ऑफ द आइदर साइड्स. ओके, नाउ सी हियर यू विल फाइंड द डिफरेंस बिटवीन ऑल द थिंग्स. पॉइंट, सो दिस इज अ पिक्चर ऑफ पॉइंट. ओके, लाइन, हियर यू कैन सी इन लाइन there are two arrows which indicates that we can the line is endless and we can extend it to any limit. Okay, it is infinite and we can extend it to any direction. This side also we can extend and this side also we can extend, it depends on our wish. Line segment has two end points and the length is very definite. Agar 5 cm hai ya 4 cm, we cannot extend it to 4.5 cm or 4.2 cm or 3.8 cm. So the length is fixed. Jitni length hai utni hi badi line segment banegi. Okay, in ray it has one end point and it can be extended into one direction. Isme ek one end point hota hai aur ek taraf hum isko बड़ा कर सकते हैं. नाउ सी द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. नाउ द नेक्स्ट थिंग दैट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इज रेडियस. नाउ डू यू नो व्हाट इज रेडियस? थ्रू द पिक्चर ओनली इट इज वेरी क्लियर चिल्ड्रन दैट द लाइन विच जॉइंस द सेंटर टू द सर्कल. ओके, दिस इज अ सर्कल, एवरीवन नोज व्हाट इज अ सर्कल. यस, अ राउंड शेप. सर्कल इज अ राउंड शेप. सो a point, what is radius? A line which joins the center, which whose one point is at the center and the other point is on the circle. जिसका एक point आपका center है और दूसरा point क्या है आपका circle पे है. That is known as radius. Okay? What is center? But before studying radius, children, you should know what is center. The center of a circle is the point inside a circle that is the same distance from each point on the circle. Okay, so what is center? You all have seen circle, sabne circle dekha hai na. So circle center is the middle point, the center most point, ekdam beecho beech jo point hota hai jahan pe hum pencil hum compass rakh ke we draw a circle, that point is known as center of a circle. Okay, so center is the middle point, the center point of a circle from where we put the compass and draw the circle, and it is equal, it is same distance from the each point on the circle. So center kisi bhi jagah ka beech is the is same distance. Aap circle se kahin se bhi line draw karoge to the center, the line will be of same length as line will be of same length. Okay, now what is circumference? Circumference, see children, circumference is the thickness of the circle. Circumference is the thickness of the circle. See, this is the circle, this is the circle. You can see this is the outer part of the circle. Outer part of circle is known as circumference. It shows the thickness of the circle. Then see, this is the line which is known as diameter. Diameter is the line which divides a circle into two equal parts. Okay. So, diameter is the line which divides circle into two equal parts. Radius is the line which comes from the center of the circle and it goes to the circle. Okay. Now, we will study about radius. Okay. Radius. Now, in the picture you can see this is the center of the circle. Center, I have told you. सेंटर ऑफ द सर्कल यू विल ड्रॉ एनी लाइन आप कोई भी लाइन ड्रॉ करेंगे इट विल बी ऑफ सेम डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द सेंटर टू द सर्कल ओके सो इट इज द सेंटर मोस्ट पॉइंट वेयर सेंटर इज देयर सेंटर ऑफ द सर्कल ओके एंड वॉट इज रेडियस रेडियस इज अ लाइन विच जॉइंस विच कम्स थ्रू द सेंटर एंड विच जॉइंस टू द सर्कल जो कहां से कहां तक जाती है इट स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम सेंटर ऑफ द सर्कल एंड इट कम्स टू द आउटर पार्ट ऑफ द सर्कल नाउ सी व्हाट इज रेडियस अ लाइन सेगमेंट बिटवीन एनी पॉइंट ऑफ अ सर्कल और स्फीयर एंड इट्स सेंटर ऑल द रेडियाई ऑफ सर्कल आर इक्वल सो ऑल द रेडियाई ऑफ सर्कल आर इक्वल द प्लूरल ऑफ रेडियस इज रेडियाई सो व्हाट इज द प्लूरल ऑफ रेडियस Radii. Now see children, this is the center of the circle. Okay. This is a circle, everyone knows. And this is the radius AB. Radius, you can see here in the picture, it is very clear that radius starts from the center of the circle and it goes to the circle. Okay. Now we will study about diameter. What is diameter? The diameter is the length of the line through the center that touches two points on the edge of the circle. A diameter divides a circle into two equal parts. This I have told you. Diameter divides a circle into two equal parts and it is the line which is drawn from the center of the circle and it touches the two end points of the circle. It touches the edges of the circle. जो बीच में से जाती है and it goes to the edges of the circle. Now I will show you the picture. Through the picture your concept will be more clear. See children, this is diameter. What is it doing? क्या कर रही है? It is dividing this circle into two equal parts. Okay? And it starts from the center, middle. Is drawn from the middle and it goes to the both the edges of the circle. Okay? It starts from middle and it goes to both the edges of the circle. So, this is diameter which divides a circle into two equal parts. Now, we will study about semicircle. What is semicircle? See, this you can see half circle. Half circle is semicircle. Okay? Half circle is semicircle. A semicircle is formed when a lining passing through the center touches the two ends of the circle. Okay. So, a semicircle is formed when a line passing through the center touches the two ends of on the circle. See. Now, we will study about chord. Okay. What is chord? You can see. It is touching the both the points on the circle. PQ is a chord. What is a chord? A chord of a circle is a straight line segment whose end points both lie on the circle. Okay? So, a chord of a circle is a straight line segment whose end points both lie on the center of the circle. Now again see all of you. Chord of a circle is a straight line segment whose end points both lie on the circle. So the end points are on the circle and it is a straight line segment. Okay. This is a chord. See, this is a line segment. okay, it is a straight line segment and its end point is on the edges of the circle. This is known as chord. Arc. Now we will study about arc. See what is arc? An arc of a circle is a portion of the circumference of the circle. An arc of a circle is a portion of the circumference of the circle. Now, through the picture, I'll show you what is arc. See, arc of a circle is the circumference of the circle. That means it shows the division of the circle. It shows the thickness of the circle. Now we will study about open and closed shapes. Now some shapes you will find that they are open shapes and some shapes you will find that they are closed shapes. Now see the difference between open and closed shapes. First we will study about what is open shape. In geometry, an open shape can be defined as a shape or figure whose line segments or curves do not meet. Okay, so open shape is a shape which is whose line segments do not meet. Jo aapas mein judte nahi hai. They do not start and end at the same point. Wo jis point se start hote hain, us point pe aake khatam nahi hote hain. Okay, so wo kahin na kahin they are open in shape. They are open shape. That is why they are termed as open shape. They are open. The figure is open. It is not complete figure. That is why they are known as open shape. Now, see the example of open shape. You can see in this figure, it is open from this side. Yes, it is open from this side. Same is the case with this figure also. You can see it is open from this side. This side also, you can see in this shape, children, this side is open. This side, this shape is also incomplete and it is open. It is also, this shape is also open in between. This shape is also incomplete. So, these are the examples of open shape. These types of shapes are not completed and they are open at some places. Now, what is closed shape? A closed shape can be defined as an enclosed shape or figure whose line segments or curves are connected or meet. They start and end at the same point. So, what is a closed shape? Closed shape is a figure which is complete and which is connected. The curves are connected or meet. The lines are connected or meet. They start and end at the same point. So, this is how you can make a difference in open and closed shape. The closed shape, they start and end at the same point. See the examples of closed shapes. In closed figure, you will not find any spaces left from where the point they are starting, they are ending at the same point. Like if we draw a square, see it very carefully. If suppose we are starting drawing this square from this point, we will draw it like this. It will come like this, like this, like this, and again will come to this point. So that means from where we were beginning this square, drawing this square, beginning this square, there only we are ending it also. Yes? Now see the example of second figure. If suppose we are drawing it like this, like this, like this, like this, like this. So from where we are beginning, making it, drawing it, and there only we are ending it also. Yes, so these are the shapes that they are complete in their form, they are closed, and from where they are being drawn, started being drawn, they end also at the same place. A simple closed plane figure formed by three or more line segments meeting only at their endpoints is called a polygon. So, what is a polygon? A simple closed plane figure. A very simple figure. Okay. And it is closed. So, there are two, three characteristics of simple closed figure or you can say a polygon. So, it should be simple. Wo simple hona chahiye. It should be closed and it should be made by either three or more line segments meeting only at their endpoints. It is known as polygon. Now see the examples of polygon. Here you can see there are different shapes They are made up of two to three or more line segments, and they are ending at the same point from where they are starting. So they are the examples of polygons. Okay. Now come to the next thing, which is simple closed figures made of line segments are called polygons. Okay. Now see. Now you all have understood what is simple closed figures. Simple closed figures made of line segments are called polygons. So they are made up of line segments and they are known as polygons. A polygon is named according to the number of sides. So how much sides are there? As per the number of the sides, it is the name is given to that polygon. Okay. Now say in triangle there are three sides. That is why it is known as triangle. And it has how many sides? Three sides. A quadrilateral has four sides. Quadrilateral has how many sides? Four sides. So any figure which has four sides, it will be known as quadrilateral. Pentagon is a figure having five sides. Okay. If a figure is having five sides, it will be known as pentagon. Hexagon is having six sides. So it is a polygon. Okay, it is a simple closed figure which is drawn with three or more line segments and they end at the end points. Okay, hexagon has six sides, heptagon has seven sides, or we can say septagon also, octagon has eight sides. Nonagon has 9 sides. You can see in this figure there are 9 sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So this figure has 9 sides. Octagon has 8 sides. Count each line segment. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So octagon has 8 sides and decagon has 10 sides. Now count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So a decagon has 10 sides. Okay. So these are the different types of polygons. Triangle has 3 sides. Quadrilateral has 4 sides. Pentagon has 5 sides. Hexagon has 6 sides. Heptagon is 7 sides. Octagon 8 sides. Nonagon 9 sides and decagon 10 sides. Okay. So children, now we have seen, today we have learnt about the various terms that are being used in geometry. Okay. I am sending you a PDF file through which you can complete your work. I am sending you a PDF file through which you can complete your today's classwork. Defines will be there that you have to write in your geometry notebook. I've told you in starting only that your geometry notebook should be a two line interleaved notebook in which one page will be blank and on the other page you will write the define. And children, how you will write the define? If suppose you are writing the define of line. Okay, agar aap point ki definition likh rahe ho, so what you will do, you will write it on the line, जहाँ पे line draw हुई है, there you will write the definition and on the blank page you will draw the diagram. Okay? तो just before point, जहाँ पे आप point की define लिखोगे, उसके just सामने आप point का figure show करोगे. Okay? So how you will write? You will write define in the printed form, जिसमें lines बनी हुई है, वहाँ पे आप define लिखोगे और उसका figure, जैसे अगर पॉइंट का फिगर है या लाइन का फिगर, आप कहाँ ड्रॉ करोगे? ऑपोजिट व्हाइट ब्लैंक पेज पे. क्लियर? अगेन आई एम टेलिंग यू, इफ यू आर राइटिंग डिफाइन ऑफ सपोज लाइन, लाइन सेगमेंट, पॉइंट, व्हाट एवर, रे, जो भी आप डिफाइन लिखोगे, उसके जस्ट सामने जो ब्लैंक पेज रहेगा, डिफाइन तो आपने लाइन वाली जगह पे लिखना है एंड फिगर यू विल ड्रॉ इन जस्ट ऑपोजिट साइड जो ब्लैंक पेज है. जैसे अगर लाइन का डिफाइन है तो उसके जस्ट सामने आप लाइन का फिगर ब्लैंक पेज पे ड्रॉ करोगे. okay? You will draw the figure on the blank page. You will not draw the figure where you are writing define. जहां पे आप define लिख रहे हो वहां पे figure नहीं draw करेंगे. You will write it in the blank opposite page. Okay, opposite में जो blank page है उस पे आप figures draw करोगे. That is why I have told you that you have to buy a geometry interleaf notebook. That is why it is required. For drawing figures, we need blank page. So, in blank page, we will draw figures. And for writing, we will use the two lines. Okay? So, I hope you all have enjoyed today's class and understood the terms that is being told you today. Go through it. Complete your PDF. Complete your classwork. And go through the defines, children. I hope you all have enjoyed today's class. We will meet again in our next class. Till then, goodbye and take care, everyone.